Hey, what's up guys, it's Tekosaur. In this video, I'm going to try out some softwares and the Samsung Galaxybook 4 Edge, which is powered by the Qualcomm X Elite ARM-based chip. I'll be testing some softwares on Windows, including those with native ARM support and others that are x86 or 64 emulated. First thing to note, I have the latest Windows update installed, including the cumulative update 24H2 for ARM64. And I also have the latest Samsung hardware update, so all updates that are available are already installed, including those from the Windows Store as well. The first thing worth noting is that the Adobe Creative Cloud has a small selection of software supported. We don't see applications like After Effects, Premiere Pro, or Adobe Illustrator. Many softwares that are available on x86 CPUs, such as Intel or AMD, aren't available natively supported yet on the ARM64. However, Adobe is working on releasing native support for them as soon as possible, so we can wait on for them and hopefully they'll arrive soon enough. Currently, only Photoshop is fully functional. If you use GIMP instead, it starts and works normally. So I got no issues with it, it starts just fine. And here they say that it automatically detects your CPU and installs the dedicated version for it. Now I want to try out MOHO Animation software because I used to do some 2D animation. And I just wanted to try if this software is going to work. And surprisingly, it worked just fine out of the box without any tinkering or modification. So you can expect that this software is going to work just fine. Now next, we'll move on to some 3D softwares, starting with my all-time favorite, Autodesk Maya. Now Maya works totally fine and I got no issues with it. It's just working out of the box normally fine. Next we have is 3ds Max. I got also no issues with it. As you can see, it's working fine. Maybe it's an emulated version, however, it's working out of the box just fine. Naturally, the most popular 3D software is going to be Blender, and here I have version 4.1, which works just fine, but however, it's emulated. So if you want the native ARM 64 version, which is still in alpha testing, you can find Blender 4.3 in the daily build section in here. Now, I don't recommend switching to it just yet, as it's still in alpha phase, so maybe you will encounter some other issues while rendering or such of stuff. However, it's worth noting that the ARM64 version should offer the best performance compared to the emulated version in terms of rendering time. Now, next 3D software we have is Rhinoceros. With this one, I encountered a weird issue. Well, it opens just fine, but however, as soon as I model any object, it crashes out of the software. The only way I got it not to crash is by running it in the safe mode. As you can see, when I use a safe mode and create any object, it just works fine, it doesn't crash or anything. Now, I'm not sure if this is a normal behavior of the software, like a bug existing also with Intel or AMD CPUs. So let me know if you experience such an issue in the comment section. Next we have is Autodesk AutoCAD, and it also seemed to run just fine with no issues at all. As you can see, it's working just fine. I also wanted to try out Cinema 4D, but unfortunately it doesn't work. As it says here, it requires a CPU with an AVX instruction support, which the X Elite doesn't have. Another favorite software of mine, Zbrush, doesn't run either. When I try to start it, nothing happens. Now I tried running it in a different emulation compatibility modes by pressing the right click and going to the properties, and then in the compatibility tab, there is these emulation settings in which we have default, safe, strict, and very strict modes, but it doesn't open in any of them. Let me know if you guys have a workaround for it or the solution. I would appreciate it because it's one of my favorite softwares of all time. Anyway guys, I just wanted to make this video to show you that some softwares may not run or give you some hard time. So please don't expect that all your softwares are going to work with this in your ARM-based notebooks. Let me know if there's any software you would like me to try in the comments below. And this footage you see of me is captured by using the Galaxybook 4 Edge camera, including also the AI enhancer features in Windows 11 Copilot version. So for example, you have the auto frame feature, like when I go to this position, it just switching framing me and zooming as well. If I switch here, it's going to follow and zoom. As you can see, it's working just fine. It's really a nice feature. And also you have the background blurring features and also the icon tag that helps you have your eyesight on the camera, not down there. For example, if you are looking down, it will show the other person that you are looking up from. And also there are some creative filters you can apply. So yeah, in terms of camera, it's really beautiful. I got no complaints. You can see the writings behind me are totally fine. The quality is okay, much more better than the old laptops I've used previously in terms of webcam. Yeah, so that was it for this video. I truly hope you found it useful. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like and subscribe to TechOSword. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next one.